much for the glory that you are indeed our honored guests. Glad that you've come. We do know that your time is precious, but the fact that you've chosen to be here, that is a blessing, and we appreciate you being here. So we acknowledge you as our honored guest. We have some of you who have filled out some cards, some welcome cards, and we acknowledge you. Of course, we know Brother Lawrence comes from the North Church of Christ, sitting right up here. Very well, Thomas. And we have Aaron and Kathy Brundage from the Linwood Church of Christ. What else?
Right.
All right, we're in the back. Hey, not unless I'm going to come up front.
Yeah. you, I'm very cautious. I understand sometimes when we are introduced in the manner in which we was, we are lifted up so high till we float, and we just don't know whether we are elevated in that way. We're humbled by Brother Joseph's announcements concerning us, but we are nobody. We're just a servant trying to make our way to heaven, and I pray that you receive us in that way. I am not God. I am a servant of God. I am not his son, Jesus Christ. However, I am his son. John 1, verse 11, I've been given that power to ever become more and more and more his son. So I am thankful that I am. Some of y'all pick up on that in a minute. Now, we've introduced a thing. The gospel, what is it? And throughout these four or five lessons, we will be introducing that name, and that in such a way possibly none of you have ever heard it. And so, with that in mind, I thought it important to help us develop the proper mind to receive the grafted word, which is able to save our soul. James 1 and verse number 21. And so, I wanted this morning, just for a few minutes, to help us understand the condition that mankind is in, why we got in that condition, and how is it that we can come out from under that condition. We have entitled this subject, for those of you keeping notes, Being in the Right Mind. Being in the right mind. If you have your Bibles, please turn to the book of Mark, chapter 5, scripture read for your hearing. And if you don't like reading, learn to like it. There's a blessing in Revelation chapter 1 that is pronounced on all of those who read. We need to read the very word of God so we can get a good understanding. I know some of you might have wanted me to come up here and give 40,000 scriptures and you'd be enamored with and lifted up with my ability to quote scripture and all that. Well, it's not about that. It's about learning and developing as we learn. And so I'm going to take my time. And then for those of you who left your pie home, maybe you got your ham in there as well. You need to hurry up and get back there. I want to help you to understand that it is appointed once on a man to die, and after death comes judgment. Hebrews 9, verse 27. You don't know whether you're going to make it home to your ham or to your pie. So is it not better to be here among those that are sanctified? Be like they have had when they set up and come, let us go. Psalm 122, verse 1, into the house of the Lord. Amen. David was ready to be among God's people so that he could hear the word of God. And so I hope that you would develop that kind of mind to not worry about the clock. Where I preach, we took the clock out. Got rid of it. And so people learned and developed over the years. We're here to worship God in spirit and in truth. So we're going to learn this morning. I wanted to say also I appreciate the leadership here very much for the invitation. And that leadership, you know who they are. I appreciate your preaching, fine preaching, and your wife. For their hospitality, for their encouragement. Took me to their home yesterday, off my shoes. Brave people have to take off your shoes now. But I appreciate Brother and Sister Joseph so much. Young man, young lady in the gospel. Always encouraging. Your leadership. Lift them up. Don't ever put them down. Even if they're wrong, don't put them down. And I want to tell you, take a page from Aquila and Priscilla, who hearing in the public Apollos preach, false doctrine. They didn't rebuke him in the public. They took him aside privately and expounded the word of God unto him more perfectly. Yeah. So don't always be ready because something is said or done by the leadership to want to put them down right in front of everybody. Don't do that. If you really care about them, if you care about their salvation, if you care about the church of which you are a member, pull them aside privately. I want to talk to you. I got some concerns. And then you all talk about those things and you work them out. Amen. It cost you nothing. That was free. Now to the subject mentioned. In the book of Mark, chapter 5, Jesus had entered over into the country of the Galileans. Now, he had been upon the Sea of Genesaret, right below Syria, and there he had taught the multitude. Y'all remember, he told the disciples, sit them down. The people are weary from their journey, they're hungry, let's feed them. And of course, those disciples being in doubt, where are you getting the food from? Jesus said, what did I tell you to do? Sit them down. We need to learn to do what the Lord commands us to do. And feed them. Well, we have nothing to feed them with. Well, there's a lad here with two fish, five barley loaves of bread. Y'all remember the account in Luke chapter 9? And now Jesus Christ, after feeding the 5,000, got in a little boat and crossed over the sea into the valley of the Galileans. And here in the valley of the Galileans, there came one possessed with a legion of demons under him. Oh, Jesus, what have we to do with thee, Son of the Most High God? Jesus said unto him, shut up and come out of the man. You know, some of us need to learn when to shut up sometimes. Amen. And in verse number 9, the Bible says in Mark 5, and he asked him, what is thy name? And he answered, saying, my name is Legion, for we're many. And he besought him much that he would not send them out of the country. Now there was there nigh unto the mountains a great herd of swine feeding, and all the devils besought him, saying, send us into the swine, that we may enter into them. Forthwith Jesus gave them leave, and the unclean spirits went out and entered into the swine, and the herd ran violently down the steep place into the sea. There were about 2,000, and were choked in the sea. And they that fed the swine fled, and told it in the city and in the country. They went out to see what it was that was done. The Bible says, verse 15, our verse, and they came to Jesus and see him that was possessed with the devil and had the legion sitting and clothed in his right mind, and they were afraid. Notice the transition from a rebellious and demon-possessed mind to a right mind. In the book of Luke, chapter 8, turn over there. And I promise you, I'll be where you want me in just a few minutes. Just come on over with me. Verse number 26. This is a parallel passage to Mark, chapter 5. Same story told by a different writer, but the same thing. Yes. The saw Jesus, he cried out and fell down before him, and with a loud voice said, "What have I to do with thee, Jesus, thou Son of God most high? I beseech thee, torment me not." For he had commanded the unclean spirit to come out of the man. For oftentimes it had caught him, and was kept bound and chained and fettered, and he brake the band and was driven of the devil into the wilderness. And Jesus asked him, saying, "What is thy name?" And he said, "Legion." We have the same story, don't we? The Bible says in verse number 34, as we skip down, and when they had fed, when they that fed them saw what was done, they fled and went and told it in the city and in the country. Then they went out to see what was done and came to Jesus and found the man out of whom the devils were departed, sitting at the feet of Jesus, clothed and in his right mind. They were afraid. Again, we see the transition from an evil mind to a right mind. Do you not know that all of humanity in its beginning had a right mind? In Genesis, the chapter is 3. Come over there with me. We're going to turn this morning. Oh, believe me, brethren, how bad we want to dig wrong. And I will run in a minute. But just stay with us. I remember when I was a boy, and my mother would set the tape, and she would teach us how to set the tape. And she would always tell us that the forks and the knives and the spoons have to go in the right place. And the plate has to be in the right place, and the saucer in the right place, and the water glass, and the teacup had to be in the right place. It had to be in the right order. And I'm trying to help you this morning to understand that we have to follow this lesson in the right order in order to get an understanding. Mm-hmm. Being in the right mind, we have to understand that when we were created, humanity was created by God. We were in our right mind. The Bible says in Genesis chapter 3 and verse number 1, "Now the heaven was subtiled in the beast of the field which the Lord God had made, and said unto the woman, Yea, have God said, ye shall not eat of every tree of the garden? And the woman said unto the serpent, We may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God had said, Ye shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die." This woman in the creation, chapter 1, where I told you to go, in verse number 7, in chapter 2, in verse number 26, God said, "Let us make man in our image, after our likeness." And God did so. He made man after his image. He made man after his likeness. And verse number 31 of Genesis chapter 1, "And God saw everything that he had made, and he said, It is good, yea, very good." Man was in that creation, and man was made very good. Thus, man was made with a sane or a right mind. But the devil came along in chapter 3.
Right.
And the devil did something to mess up that right mind. What did he do? He taught Eve something against what God had said. Have God not said that thou shalt not eat of every tree in the garden? Well, he knew that God had given that commandment. But the devil says to her, contrary to the set free so we can do anything, any way that we want to do. But Adam and Eve were no different. They wanted to be, at least Eve wanted to be set free. Mm-hmm. So when the devil told her, thou shalt not surely die, he says unto her, for God doth know that in the day ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and ye shall be as God. Look at here now. Knowing both good and evil. Mm-hmm. Now he gave her part truth. What's happening? Her mind, which was once pure, is being changed by another teaching. You know, Paul will speak to the Galatians in Galatians chapter 1, verse 6. He said, I marvel that you are so soon removed from him who called you to the grace of Christ unto another gospel, which is not another. But there be some that will trouble you and would pervert the gospel of Christ. But though we are an angel, preach unto you any gospel other than that we preached unto you, let it be anathema. What was Paul saying? How could you allow someone else to change your pure mind? Eve allowed it. Where did that get in God, didn't it? No wonder 1 Timothy chapter 2 and verse number 11, it was not Adam that was caught in the transgression, but the woman being deceived was caught in the transgression.
Wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination
found a plain in the land of Shinar, and they dwelt there. And they said one to another, go to, let us make brick and burn and furl it. And they had brick for stone, and slime had they for water. And they said, go to, let us build us a city and a tower whose top make us a name, lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth. But I already have a name. Man, is that right? God had names, but they wanted a new name. They wanted a name outside of the one that God had already given them. What are they doing? They're digressing. They're falling from pure mind to a contaminated mind, and it's becoming more and more and more and more contaminated. Because they're being taught the wrong thing. Where did it begin? In God. Where did it begin? With Satan and Eve. And so they said in verse 7, go to, God says, go to, let us go down and there do what? Confound their language, that they may not understand one another's speech. Now God has never wanted you and I not to speak the same thing.
The mind of the
leadership here were defiling the minds of the people by not teaching the true unadulterated word of God, by not giving the commands of God. Same thing with Jeremiah. Notice that in verse number 9, the heart is deceitful above what? All things, and desperately wicked. Who can know it? Who can know it? If you have a mind of Christ, and someone comes in with a message contrary to Christ, you need to know that person. Amen. And have no company with them.
We're to walk out.
become contaminated by another teaching. But we must of necessity develop in this process the mind like Christ.
Amen.
In Philippians chapter 2 and verse 5, Paul said, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought not about being with God. Listen, Jesus Christ had a mind to obey his Father.
Yeah.
Look at John 8, verse number 29. John 8, at verse number 29. I'm about to be already to eat, aren't you? You shouldn't be. I'm trying to fill you up right now.
Amen.
Amen. Look at John chapter 8 and verse number 29. I said Jesus had a mind to obey his Father. We need to have a mind of obedience.
Mm-hmm.
That's the mind of Christ. Eve chose to disobey, and so did Adam. Having that pure mind, now contaminated. We must choose to obey God in all things. Jesus said in verse number 29, and he that sent me is with me. The Father hath not left me alone. Why? For I do how often? Always those things that would please him. Jesus pleased his Father. And y'all know familiar text in Hebrews chapter 5, verse 8 and 9. Speaking of Christ, though he were a son, yet learned the obedience through the things which he suffered. And being made perfect, he became the author of eternal salvation to all them that obey him. That being made perfect is not talking about him being made without sin as he came into the earth and walked along the earth, even though he walked. But it's talking about the fulfillment of that learning process.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus obeyed. You know, 46 and verse number 50. While he yet talked to the people, the Bible said, behold, his mother and his brethren stood without, desiring to speak with him. Then one said unto him, behold, thy mother and thy brethren stand without, desiring to speak with thee. But he answered and said unto him that told him, who is my mother? And who is my brethren?
Yes.
And he stretched forth his hand towards his disciples. Listen, brethren, you need to love the church.
Amen.
You need to love the people of God. I'm not telling you not to love your family, but you can't love your family more than you love God and his people. Are y'all getting this?
Yeah.
Oh, to have the mind of Christ is to love God more than food. It's to love God more than your family.
Mm-hmm.
You need to understand that you cannot have an humble and obedient mind putting family ahead of God's will. The Bible says in Luke chapter 14 and verse number 26. Luke 14 and verse number 26. I'm going down here, but I'm going to run because I know this is a touchy subject when you talk about family.
Yeah.
I don't care what you say. My family comes before anybody. That's that evil mind.
Yeah.
And there's no way you're going to receive the things that I'm trying to present to you from the Word of God with that kind of mind.
Yes,
it's not going to happen. You've got to own yourself to be obedient to the Word of God. Receiving with meekness the implanted word or engrafted word, the King James said, that which is able to save your soul. Notice what Jesus said. If any man come to me, does your Bible say that? If any man come to me and hate not his father and mother and wife and children and brethren and sisters, yea, and his own life also, he cannot be my disciple. He wasn't telling you to hate as to have disdain and total despite. But you cannot put family before him.
Mm-hmm.
He further explains it in Matthew's account, in Matthew chapter 10 and verse 37 through verse number 38. Matthew chapter 10, 37 and 38. Sit on up in the seat, y'all. I know it's been long, but hell is eternal. We got a short time here. For what is your life? It's even a vapor that appears for a short time, passes away. You know, the start of anything is always the longest. And once you get this part right, then you can give a little bit here and a little bit there and move on. What am I saying? If you get this during the week, these other four lessons, amen. But you got to get this, y'all.
Yes.
If you don't get this, your mind is not right.
Mm-hmm.
And so no matter what I show you during the week, you're not going to receive. Amen. Notice what Jesus says. He that loveth father or mother what? More than me is not worthy of me. And he that loveth son or daughter what? More than me is not worthy of me. And he that taketh not his cross and followeth after me is what? Not worthy of me. Jesus becomes our family, y'all.
Yeah.
He is put before our very blood children,
yeah,
our own wife, mother, daddy, aunt, uncle, cousin.
Yeah.
When it comes to God, he is to be first.
Yeah.
No wonder Jesus said, seek ye first the kingdom. All the things you need, Matthew 6:33, shall be added unto you, and all these things shall be added unto you. Jesus becomes our family. In Mark chapter 10 and verse number 29, Mark 10 and verse number 29, Bible says, and Jesus answered and said, verily I say unto you, there is no man that has left house, or brethren, or sister, or father, or mother, or wife, or children, or lands for my sake and the gospel, but he shall receive an hundredfold win now in this time. Houses and brethren and sisters and mothers and children and land with persecution and in the world to come. Eternal life. Well, what does he mean? You're going to receive a hundredfold houses and land, brothers and sisters and mothers and all of that. Do you know how many members of God's family there are? Life. I'm willing to obey thee. I believe in thee. Mm-hmm. I will confess your name before men. Romans 10 and 10. Bible says, but with the heart. See what comes first? With the heart, man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. Come down and confess the sweetest name ever mentioned on mortal tongue. And then be buried with him. Romans 6, 1 through verse 1 4. Buried with him, Colossians chapter 1, verse 12 through 16. Buried with him in baptism, wherein also we are risen with him, Colossians 2, 12, through the faith of the operation of God, who raised him from the dead. Or if you hear this word, believe him to be God's son. That's Jesus Christ. Make that mind up right now. No one can make it up for you, y'all. It takes the word of God. You heard it? Do you believe? Repent me. Change that mind. Confess his name before me. Surrender to the water grave of baptism for the remission of your sin. Acts 2:38. And here's the beauty of it. He adds to his body the church. Ephesians chapter 1. And verse number 22, Colossians 3:18. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. If any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away. What has passed away? And behold, all things have become new. Are you here this morning? Are you willing right now, having changed your mind, to confess it before men? The water is ready. I know it's ready. The water was ready. Baptizing, gave the invitation one time, man came down and wanted to be baptized, and we took his confession and went to baptize, and he saw a roach in the water. And he says, I'm not getting in that contaminated water. And Brother Lee Thomas was going to baptize, and he said, well, what made it contaminated? He said, it roach. He said, your sin was dirtier than that roach. I know that's wrong, but boy, that's the truth. Amen. Your sins are far more contaminated than that roach.
Amen.
So don't worry about the kind of water. Mm-hmm. John was baptized near Ain, Jordan, because there was much water there. You know what that sea contained by that? It was dirty place. Those folks weren't caring about the water. They wanted their sins committed. You have them committed.
Amen.